So what did the Sydney Opera House, the Eiffel Tower in Paris, and the Tesla Cybertruck all have in common? Well, they all initially suffered from a polarizing or a mixed public reaction as far as its aesthetics are concerned. But we all know the Sydney Opera House is an architectural marvel now. We all love it. Tourists come from all over the world to marvel at it. It adds $1 billion to the Australian economy each year. It's a UNESCO World Heritage Site. I mean, do I even need to get started about the Eiffel Tower? Hopefully not. So we all grew to love these pieces of architecture, if you like, over time. But at the time that they were built, let me just read you a quote. So this is to do with the Sydney Opera House. The winning design thrilled the architectural profession, but the public reaction was fairly mixed. Bemused letter writers to the Sydney Morning Herald described it as Danish pastry, an armadillo, a disintegrating circus tent, the Loch Ness Monster, an instinct which had crawled out from under a log. Sounds eerily similar to what some people are saying about the Cybertruck. This is another quote about the Eiffel Tower in Paris. At the time, the project was deemed a disaster by France's best aesthetic minds and seen as a World's Fair gimmick that would hopefully be demolished as soon as possible. And the public almost had its way in 1909. They almost were successful in getting rid of it. But we all obviously love it now. So how come some things we have a mixed reaction to, but get to absolutely love over time? I tried to Google a couple of things and came up with the mere exposure effect or the familiarity effect. The mere exposure effect says that we're often like things merely because we are familiar with them, because it's easy to understand, it's easy to process for us. Something that's new, completely bold and completely avant-garde and comes from left field, we sometimes find hard to process. And that initial inability to process, we interpret perhaps as us disliking it. But over time, we actually get to like it. And I bet you this is the case with the Cybertruck. Already, I'm hearing people that had quite strong negative opinions in regards to the aesthetic now starting to slowly come around. It's only been a few days, mind you. Now there's, Elon just tweeted, there's 250,000 pre-orders for the truck now. There was only about 150,000 during the first 48 hours. And usually the first few hours is where you get the bulk of your orders. So that would suggest to me that people are starting to slowly get accustomed to the looks, and the looks are starting to slowly grow on them. The more they look at it, the more it seems to grow on them. And look, some people will say, well, you know, you're comparing this to the Eiffel Tower, which was built 130 years ago, to the Sydney Opera House, built 150 years ago. We had a long time to get used to these things. We're not going to get this time with the Cybertruck. It's either going to work or it's going to be a flop. Well, sure, we might not have 150 years. By the way, it didn't take 150 years for us to like the Opera House. But I think this process will be fairly quick. And I'll tell you what makes me say that. Have you noticed there has been hardly any negative opinion in regards to the Cybertruck's interior? Now, the interior, you could say, is as out there, as avant-garde as the exterior, except for the Model 3. The Model 3, which came out 3 years ago, and we got a glance at its interior a little bit earlier before that, we've had a few years to become accustomed to it. And people loved the Model 3 interior when they took delivery of the car. But initially, when the sketches came out, people just couldn't get their head around the cluster panel not being there, the instrument panel not being able to have that in front of your steering wheel. I mean, the number of people that were saying, look, we need a heads-up display, this is ridiculous, you need to have something in front of the steering wheel. And there was all sorts of comments and lots of reaction to this bizarre interior initially. Now we all love it. I mean, it took me about 3 minutes to get used to not having a cluster panel in front of the steering wheel when I took delivery of my Model 3, and that seems to be the opinion of everyone else. And I've given drives to 72-year-olds, 80-year-olds, and it's taken them 5 minutes to get used to the no cluster panel. So, and it's not, and it wasn't an issue. So this is, I think, just a whole lot of rhetoric where people are just really stunned by this really out there design. I actually don't think it's that much out there. I think it's fantastic. I love it. My initial reaction was I cracked up laughing. So when the car first came out, and that was probably my reaction to struggling to process it as well, I was just laughing. And then after about 20 seconds, I looked at it, then I took another look at it, then I took another look at it and thought, you know what? I think I actually like it. But it did take me some time to, and I actually had to stop and ask myself, do I like this? And once I had to think about it, once I looked at it objectively with an open mind, I realized that I did like it. And over the last few days, I liked it initially and I like it even more now. And people that may have disliked it initially are slowly starting to come around already. Maybe people that had really, really strong opinions that they put out there in the public, maybe it will be too hard for them to completely shift their opinion. Maybe their egos will get in the way, who knows? That's human nature. But I think we'll all find that in 2 years' time, this is going to be a automotive icon, a little bit like the Opera House is an architectural icon, a little bit like the Eiffel Tower is an architectural icon. And, you know, just think about it in your own life. Think about all the songs that you first heard and didn't like, but then over time, you grew to like them. And, you know, this is not unheard of. This is prevalent in, I'll go through, and I'll find some web pages, examples of, I think, light globes were initially thought of as a fad or something that wouldn't, you know, bicycles people thought was a fad, and, you know, personal computers, you know, people thought that, you know, that was just a fad, that would go away, that was silly. So I'll put some of those up on the video as well. But before I go, I'll leave you with some great imagery of the Cybertruck. Put to some music, courtesy of Tesla. And hopefully by watching that video, you'll get to like it just that little bit more. And I encourage you to look at the designs more and more. And as new imagery and videos come out of the Cybertruck, look at it, pause, have a think as to whether you like it or not. And keep an open mind. As long as you've got an open mind, I'm sure you'll get to love the aesthetics. If not love them, maybe you'll get to like them. The Model 3 aesthetics were a little bit like that as well. People loved the Model S and the Model S, but not necessarily the Model 3. With the Model S, it was sort of eased on us. First, we had the vent at the front or the air intake. So we got to become familiar with the car overall, with the front of the car basically being very familiar to us. And so it was sort of eased. We were eased into it, if you like. And then the Model 3, some people didn't like the front. You know, it's interesting they didn't like the front. Everyone liked the back. Why? The back was familiar. It looked pretty much exactly the same as the Model S. So, I'll leave you with some imagery and hopefully you'll get to like the Cybertruck over time. If you don't already, let me know in the comment section. Would love to hear your comments and your first reactions and what you think about the truck now. This sort of content, please subscribe, please forward it on to anyone else that you think may find it interesting. Please make sure you give it a like if you thought this was okay or at least entertaining, and please make sure you press the notification bell next to the subscribe button so you can get alerted to these videos. I'll also include my Tesla link in the description below. So this is a website, URL, that you can click on. It will take you to the Tesla website where you can put an order in for a Model 3, Model S, Model X if you're in the market for one. As I said in one of my earlier videos, I think full self-driving will be going up by about $1,500 Australian from $8,500 to $10,000 as an optional extra. And that will keep on occurring as new updates come out, as the product gets more capable. So keep that in mind as well. That's about it from me for now. So until the next video, my name is Pete. You're watching Ahead of the Curve. As always, stay safe, stay sustainable, and stay ahead of the curve. Ciao.